We need for this the idea of what a gradient is. And hence, I have presented a few aspects of this. First of all, let's start with observation. We are looking at a differentiable function. To directly spoil a problem, this is not differentiable. The gradient of a differentiable function, it's usually written as nabla. The word, this operator is called nabla, f of a differentiable function of several variables is a vector whose components are the partial derivatives. That means we, if we have a two-dimensional situation here with x1 and x2, we could compute two derivative in two dimensions. I have the Wikipedia thing here. The gradient is, if you look on the on a loss or a function curve, this is a function f, and the gradient now characterizes how to, in which direction to go, or if I go a certain step, whether I go into the direction of steepest descent. And the gradient shows us the direction of steepest descent. And if you know the direction of steepest descent, you know the shortest path to go to an extreme. This can be you are going down or you are going up, but if you know this direction of steepest ascent or descent, if you know the gradient, you know how to come to get to your goal in the quickest way. And this is what we will do now. We will take a differentiable function, namely our loss or problematic distances, compute the gradient, and then we move into the direction of the gradient. And this is exactly what happens here. This is a move in the gradient direction. And perhaps you have seen this already before, because you saw this is a linear function. A linear function is the result of the derivation of a quadratic function. The quadratic function could encode the residual squared loss. Perhaps you have seen this already somehow. If not, here comes the explanation. This is a move in the gradient direction. Why? This explanation comes now. What I present in this regard is the model function which we want to optimize, for instance, a linear model. The loss which we incur with a certain decision. For instance, you see the linear model which gives us this point here has wrong classifications. For instance, for this minus here, this is not correct. This should be on the other side. And this line here would be better. And these lines go into this weight vector, and from these differences here, we compute the loss. And here we do nothing complicated. We compute the loss as a squared difference from the correct value. Other losses are possible, but let's say we start with this loss. And if we do this, we can say, for this certain weight vector, which we have chosen here, this wave, V vector, this or W vector, this has a certain W0 component and a certain W1 component. For this certain V vector, we have a certain loss. And for another W vector, we have another loss. In fact, it looks something like this. For each vector, we have a loss. And these vectors correspond to these lines, which you see here. And now, with the idea of gradient descent, we want to choose that combination of W0 and W1, that weight vector, which incurs the minimum loss. And what you see here hinted with this red arrow is that we go, of course, the quickest way. Why should we go here around? Why should we do this? We go directly to the minimum. That means our task now is to look at this function here, which produces this green yellow hull, which you see here, this plane, to look at this function, compute its derivative. This is shown here, it's the Nabla operator, and go into this direction. Your decision was the following. You use a linear model, a linear regression, let's say this way, I like to say this way, plus squared loss. These are your decisions. Now the mathematician comes, computes you and gives you the Nabla operator, that means the vector of partial derivatives, that means it gives you the gradient. And then we have the value that you simply plug in here. That means all what we have to do now is to compute the derivative of L2. And this is, I will do this, I will jump about a few slides. This will show other Hall curves and show you where this happens. Here again is the idea. We want to correct the W vector with a gradient. And in this regard, you can jump between the slides if you're looking on the slides by yourself later on. In this regard, we compute now the derivative of this loss function. And this happens component-wise. You see it directly here. I look for each component in isolation. These are our P+1 dimensions of the vector. And we compute the partial derivative of the loss function. And now a little bit of calculus happens, nothing complicated. The partial derivative of this function, here happens nothing, means we can pull it into the sum. Here has also nothing happened. Now you have to form the derivative of this squared function. You do this as a chain rule. Outer derivative 2 times something times inner derivative. Here, 2 times something, what we had, times inner derivative. The inner derivative is not so complicated. We want to compute the derivative with regard to the J dimension. Here we have W0, W1, W2, and with regard to J, they are all constant. It means from this vector here, where we have something like this, only this is not constant regarding the interesting variable according to which we form the derivative, and so if we compute the derivative, we get xj. Yeah. I see I have extra step here. This was done here. And here, and now we compute the derivative. So, yeah, here see this xj which comes from this here. And this, in fact, this is our update rule. And this is what we have plugged into the algorithm. Yeah. Here's the x, here's the difference. And I see now that I presented a lot. I also see that we have been talking now about 1 hour. And I think I do not move forward in the material now, but I do a kind of recap and present a few other graphics. Okay, what I wanted to do, a bit of a recap. I think it was enough material for today. Go back to the gradient descent. What was the idea? The idea was that we have a noisy situation. We cannot linearly separate, and hence we cannot use the PT algorithm, and we now exploit the residuals. And if we analyze the residuums for different variants of our weight vector, we get such a curve, a loss curve. And in this loss curve, we want to go to the minimum, in that sense, find the weight vector which produces the smallest loss, and we do this with the gradient. And the gradient is plugged in the gradient descent algorithms. And now in machine learning, this is what we have compiled for you. The difference of the algorithms result from the difference of these loss curves. And first of all, it is clear that we have to do efficiently, and also, of course, then effectively compute this minimum, we have a certain easy optimization situation. You see, this loss curve is convex. And if it would not be convex, we would not be able to find its minimum with this hill climbing method, this gradient descent. And if we simply always would use the squared loss, we would not be able to create convex curves, for instance, for logistic regression. This does not work. And this is what I show you now. If we think of linear regression, let's start with this, and the 0-1 loss, then we compute something like the perceptron algorithm. The 0-1 loss means that we apply the Heaviside function here, or the sign, this is quite similar as the scalar product. And of course, we get for a certain misclassification situation, that means for a certain hyperplane, a certain loss. But this is how this entire picture looks. And this is only in two dimensions. You see, the algorithm, the optimization algorithm, has a problem here. Where to go? All points are equal. And similar, here this is a situation where we cannot find the derivative. Although we are in fact interested in the 0-1 loss, because the 0-1 loss tells us the true classification performance, we cannot use the 0-1 loss here for guiding the search. And now you understand why we presented all these things here. This here is a regression, this is nice, but this is a classification situation. And we mapped this classification situation on a regression situation. And we did this not accidentally five lessons back. We had already this in mind, what we present today. We wanted you to show that we have a discrete situation which we deal with a continuous solution. This has drawbacks and benefits. And the 0-1 loss is that what we originally need, and this is what we can compute. You also saw the logistic regression, and we had the logistic regression with regularization. This means we do not consider such curves, or let's write it this way, but we consider such curves, which are not so steep here in the middle. This is a consequence of regularization. And also here we can compute the loss, of course, with a regularization term here. And this is how this looks. This means you see also this is a convex situation. And we can use the gradient to quickly find the minimum. If we would use the squared loss, we would not end up in such a nice function. And instead, we use the so-called logistic loss, and perhaps you saw, does not work. Here, we presented this, but we need not explain where it comes from. And in fact, the logistic loss, it can be derived with the maximum likelihood considerations, like the squared loss is derived from Gaussian considerations. And if you form the derivative from this here, you get such a curve. The logistic loss plus regularization applied in the gradient descent algorithm is one of the strongest learning algorithms that you can do in the classical sense. And what we wanted to present to you, and this is also part of the readings, where these elements come from. Normally, the people get only presented, this is an algorithm. Sorry, that's not here. Here's the algorithm, and now use this. But why it works, this has been explained today. Okay, this is a good situation now to stop this, and for you to think about what you have learned, what you have seen, and of course, you can simply implement them and then you will see how strong they are in the classification. What we presented in this reading is why they are so strong and which considerations led to their development. And we wanted to remove from you every kind of mystery because we see the pressure of, I told it already a few weeks ago about explainable AI. AI cannot be explained by saying this has to be done this way and this is a simple rule. The true explanation comes from this mathematics here. And here you see which data has which influence and how deal algorithm with it, user algorithms deal with this data. And we want to present you the entire picture, and this led to the explanation and the derivation of the gradient method for the linear regression, but also for the logistic regression. Next week, I will do a short recap of this, then continue to multilayer perceptrons to show that this all makes sense, what we are doing here. And to conclude our linear models, later on, we will go to support vector machines. With this knowledge in background, you are very well equipped to solve learning tasks. Yeah, thank you very much for listening. I know it was a lot of material, and I'm very happy that you're interested and join us and try to learn this. Thank you, Erin. And thank you also to the strong PTs, the technical assistants and TAs, sorry, not PTs, and who help us to develop this realistic and great solutions in the lab classes to make you, bring you touch feeling to machine learning. And I'm very happy about this. It's a job which I cannot do. Thank you again.